Morning, everyone. I had a chance to brief the president on the travels that I returned from last evening, where I had traveled both to Riyadh and Ankara. Had a chance to talk with in Riyadh with the king, with the crown prince, with the foreign minister, all of the United States counterparts there. We made clear to them that we take this matter with respect to Mr. Khashoggi very seriously. They made clear to me that they too understand the serious nature of the disappearance of Mr. Khashoggi. They also assured me that they will conduct a complete, thorough investigation of all of the facts surrounding Mr. Khashoggi, and that they will do so in a timely fashion, and that this report itself will be transparent for everyone to see, to ask questions about, and to inquire with respect to its thoroughness. And I told President Trump this morning that we ought to give them a few more days to complete that, so that we too have a complete understanding of the facts surrounding that, at which point we can make decisions about how or if the United States should respond to the incident surrounding Mr. Khashoggi. I think it's important for us all to remember, too, we have a long, since 1932, a long strategic relationship with the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. They continue to be an important counterterrorism partner. They have custody of the two holy sites. They are an important strategic alliance of the United States, and we need to be mindful of that as well. We're all going to get to see the response that the Kingdom of Saudi Arabia takes with this. When we see that, we'll get a chance to determine, all of us will get a chance to make a determination with respect to the credibility and the work that went into that, whether it's truly accurate, fair, transparent, in the very way that they made a personal commitment to me. And the Crown Prince also made a personal commitment to the president when he spoke to him, I believe it was night before last.